What's your association with the word etiquette? Something old-fashioned, like gentlemen in top hats and ladies with teacups in their gloved hands? Well, this picture has nothing to do with modern etiquette habits. If you want to be perceived as a well-mannered, polite, and respected person, you might want to brush up on this topic. Don't worry, I'll guide you through it. Life likes to throw us a curve every now and then, such as, let's say, ripping your pants at the worst possible moment. You can find tons of recommendations on how to solve this problem online, ranging from wrapping a sweater around your waist to stapling along the inner seam. Ouch! But whatever you do, remember that you should neither tell anyone about this problem nor let your underwear show in public. Imagine this. You're eating out with your friends, and at the end of the meal, they decide to split the bill. But hey, all you had was a Coke and a salad while your dining partners were munching on pizzas and burgers. In this case, you have two options. Either you round the approximate cost of your meal to a bigger sum and leave this amount, or you join the rest of your friends in splitting the bill evenly. In case of bathroom etiquette, yes, it does exist. If you see that a stall is closed, don't try to open the door. It may accidentally open, and both you and the person inside will feel extremely embarrassed. Guys should try to keep some space between each other by skipping urinals, if the bathroom isn't crammed, that is. While applying makeup or combing your hair, use the mirror furthest from the hand dryer. Otherwise, people who only need to dry their hands will have to wait until you finish. If you need to blow your nose, do it really quietly and quickly. Don't do it in a public place if you can avoid it. Find some place where you'll be alone. On the other hand, if you know you can manage to clean your nose quietly and are only surrounded by friends or relatives, never ever do it at the dining table. Leave the table and go to the restroom. And then let her honk. On top of that, it's bad manners to use a toothpick at the table. If you know for sure something is stuck between your teeth, go to the bathroom and get rid of it there. On that note, if another person has the same problem and they haven't noticed it yet, don't stay silent. Make sure that no one else can hear you and quietly inform your neighbor about the issue. One of my eternal nightmares is to find out that my fly is unzipped in public. Can you imagine anything more embarrassing? Well, yes, but I won't go into it here. That would be bad manners. As for the undead, I mean unzipped, according to the etiquette norms, you need to go to the restroom and only there zip up your pants. Otherwise, if there's no restroom close by, you can turn to the wall and do your fly up. If you spot someone else walking around with an unzipped fly, you should inform this person immediately. But again, do it privately and quietly. Telling another person that something is wrong with them is a very sensitive subject. Maybe they smell bad, or use very strong perfume in the office, or chew with their mouth open. If you choose to be a negotiator, talk to this person in private. Tell them, "It's kind of an unpleasant topic, but I know you'd want to know about it." In this case, you will indicate that you want to help, not make a joke. Then, after you explain the issue, tell this person that you spoke to them because you're their friend. At the end, you may ask if the person feels offended. It will assure them that you had their best interest at heart. It's good manners to offer a seat to a pregnant woman. But let's admit it, the situation can get more embarrassing than when you confuse an overweight woman for a pregnant one. Oops! To avoid such a situation, look at the woman's feet. Pregnant women prefer to steer clear of high heels. Also, their ankles are often swollen, and they may be holding their lower back or transferring their weight from one leg to another. At the same time, the best thing to do is to silently stand up so that the woman can decide whether she wants to sit down or not. If you want to take a selfie with someone, you should ask for that person's permission first, even if it's your close friend. You should give them some time to prepare for the photo. Also, it's considered bad manners to take selfies in bathrooms. Yes, it is. Avoid wearing clothes with offensive logos and bad words. Some people might perceive such a t-shirt as a joke, but others might get offended. If you aren't going to drink wine, there's no need to turn your glass upside down to save it from being filled. Without creating much fuss, just cover the rim with your fingertips and say, "Not today, thank you." When you're in the boarding area at the airport, don't crowd in front of the gate. Also, when claiming your suitcase, step toward the carousel only after you've spotted your bag. Otherwise, you may get in the way of other passengers who are trying to get to their baggage. Always inform a person that they are on speakerphone and that there are other people in the room. If you talk to someone on speakerphone at work, find a separate room and close the door. If you use your office microwave to heat your lunch up, you should never put anything inside with a strong and lingering smell. If all you want to write in your email is "thank you," avoid sending it. You will just clog the recipient's inbox. Thank you. On top of that, remember these other no-nos when sending an email. Do not use all capital letters. In messaging, it means shouting. Also, do not use emoticons and colored fonts in business emails. Try not to attach large files. And don't forward an email unless it's okay to do so. While you can send work emails at any time of the day, don't send business-related texts earlier than 1 hour before the workday starts and 2 hours after it finishes. If you need to squeeze a lemon over your dish or into your drink, shield it with your hand. Otherwise, as Murphy's Law goes, you'll most likely squirt the acidic juice right in your companion's eye. Trust me on this one. If you're dining out with your family or friends, it's absolutely okay to ask the staff to wrap your leftovers, even if it's a fancy restaurant. But never ask for leftovers after a business lunch or dinner. When you're invited to a wedding, don't ask to bring a guest with you unless your invitation indicates that you may. However, if your marital status changes before the wedding reception, you may tell the hosts about it and wait for their answer. It's okay to follow your boss on Twitter, but don't try to befriend them. Being friends, even if it's just in social media, means equality, which you don't have at the moment. You should hold a cup of tea and a cup of coffee in different ways. If it's a teacup, don't loop your index finger into the handle. Let it meet your thumb inside the handle instead, as if you're pinching something. As for your middle finger, it should support the handle from below. At the same time, while drinking coffee, loop your index finger into the handle while your thumb goes to the top of the handle. Tuck the three remaining fingers into your palm. Now, I guess everyone has burned their mouths on spicy food. Instead of breathing through a wide-open mouth or spitting the food out, take a gulp of cold water or other drink. Works like magic every time. So, what other modern etiquette rules do you know? Let me know down in the comments. If you learned something new today, then give this video a like and share it with a friend. But hey, don't go anywhere just yet. We have over 2,000 cool videos for you to check out. All you have to do is pick the left or right video, click on it, and enjoy. Stay on the bright side of life.